I'm Roger Mason, and I reported the discovery of the Ediacaran fossil, which is behind me, in 1957. At that time, I was in secondary school at the Wiggiston Boys School in Leicester, and I went rock climbing in Charnwood Forest with two companions, Richard Blatchford and Richard Allen. The fossil occurred in a sloping slab, and our climbing involved climbing up the steep slab. And I went to the top to lower the rope, and Richard Allen was preparing to climb. Richard Blatchford walked around at the bottom of the slab and called up to me that he'd seen something that looked like a leaf as a fossil. I knew enough geology to know that the rocks in Charnwood Forest were too old to contain fossils. They were Precambrian. So I went down and had a look, and it certainly was a very clear fossil. On a later visit, I made a rubbing of the fossil. I put a piece of paper over it and rubbed a wax crayon on top of the paper. My father showed this to Trevor Ford of Leicester University's geology department. So Trevor agreed to come and look at the fossil in the quarry. We met him after I had finished school on the 30th of May 1957. And my father kept a diary, and so I'm certain of that date. Dr. Ford didn't believe that this was a fossil, and when we reached the quarry where the fossil occurred, and we showed him the fossil, and he very famously said, "My God, it is." The result of that was that, encouraged by the first professor of geology at Leicester University, Professor Sylvester Bradley, Dr. Ford wrote a paper quite quickly for the Journal of the Yorkshire Geological Society, of which Professor Sylvester Bradley was the editor. And this article appeared early in 1958. He also took Sir James Stubblefield, the director of the British Geological Survey, which in those days had its headquarters in London, to see the fossil later in the summer of 1967. And the news came out into the geological community. In the early years of the 2000s, I spoke about the discovery of Charnia for a country natural history program presented by Alan Titchmarsh, which was shown in the Midland region of the BBC, but not countrywide. And a few weeks later, I received an email from Tina Negus, who said, "You've seen my fossil." And she was about my age and regularly visited Charnwood Forest with her parents and had seen the same Charnia that's now in Leicester Museum. And she then went to Leicester Museum, confirmed that it was the fossil she'd seen, but she'd spoken to her school teachers, who didn't believe her, because everyone knew that the rocks in Charnwood Forest were too old to contain fossils. And so for nearly 50 years, she hadn't realized that she really did see the fossil. And I'm very pleased that when we celebrated the 50th anniversary, she was able to come and join us for the meetings and the ceremony. And she's since been back several times to contribute to television programs about the discovery of Charnia. I think what this story tells us is, if you do make an interesting discovery, it's quite important to go beyond your school teachers and approach your local museum or your local geological society or your local college and find someone expert to look at your fossil and tell you whether it's real or not.